Dear friends in Christ, good morning, good afternoon. Today, we are reflecting one of the great beatitude of our Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed are the peacemakers, they shall be called children of God. Blessed are the peacemakers, they shall be called children of God. This is the only beatitude talks about peace, as well as whoever make peace are called a child of God. If they are, they are called children of God. Let us, friends, reflect a little bit about the concept of peace in the scripture. Scripture proclaims our God, the Lord Adonai, Yahweh, as the Lord of peace and justice. And in the scripture, the peace and justice intertwine and mingle and connect together. In fact, Psalmist proclaimed, justice and peace kisses each other. Just so connected, there is no peace without justice in the scripture. I think this is very important that as followers of our Lord Jesus Christ that we understand. Because our Lord is a Lord of peace with justice. Our Lord is a Lord of peace and justice. And in the scripture, that is called in Hebrew language, Shalom. Yes, peace and justice will Shalom. Justice is the basis of Shalom. Now a God is a God of Shalom, that means overflowing love and compassion of God. In other words, Shalom means the wholeness of all creation. It speaks about the wholesome person, the person as a holistic person. And that means if you want peace, that refers to peace of mind, peace of heart, peace in the body, peace in our emotions, peace in the spirit. So every aspect included in this peace. But when it refers to the whole humanity, peace of all people, that is called holistic peace. And when it refers to the creation, peace of all creation, that is Shalom. God's overflowing compassion and how people live in that peace. And so we understand our God is a God of Shalom, God of peace. And that God expect the people of God, us, to be peacemakers, peace builders, and curry peace wherever we go, and be peaceful people, be people of reconciliation, compassion, and love all time. But also, we have a call. We must never distract from justice. Like, you know, we have to focus that our peace is based upon justice of God. So where there is no justice, there is no peace. When there is justice, there is peace. So it is a dual calling, in a sense. You are called to make peace, because our God is a God of peace. But also you are called to do justice because our God is a God of justice. It is connected in the scripture. That build shalom. Shalom for us, shalom for our neighbor, and shalom for the whole creation. That's the biblical, the Old Testament or the First Testament aspect of peace. When it comes to the New Testament, and the Christ was prophesied by the prophets, Christ was to be the Prince of Peace. Our Lord Jesus Christ came to our world as a Prince of Peace, born as a refugee baby in Bethlehem, and he became the Prince of Peace. And he created a peaceful community based on justice and fairness. He created that first discipleship of equals, that community, first disciple community based on peace. And that is why we see in the Sermon on the Mount, Jesus proclaimed, "Blessed are the peacemakers, they shall be called children of God." In other words, blessed are the shalom makers, and they shall be called children of God. What that really means is peacemaking is an all-time task, mission that we have. You have to make peace within your own family, within your own church, within your own neighborhood, within your society, within your ethnic community, within your own nation, and beyond the nations. That is our peacemaking task. Friends, it is so relevant today as we go through so much violence, tensions, division, fragmentation of our community and society. There is war, there is woundedness, brokenness in our community. So we are called to make peace all time. So this is our role as Christians, making peace. As Saint Francis of Assisi proclaimed, "Lord, make me an instrument of your peace, your shalom. Make me an instrument of your shalom." In other words, he prayed, "Lord, make me an instrument of your justice, your compassion." That's our role. And Jesus said, this is very important, such people are children of God, our Lord. That is very important, I think. It doesn't say that the Christians are the peacemakers. It doesn't say any other people of faith are the peacemakers. Whoever are in the role of peacemaking, and in their heart, from their social capacities, if they work for peace, justice and reconciliation, they are children of God. Friends, I'm pretty sure all of you, I want to be a child of God. That's our goal. If you want to be a child of God, make peace, do justice, and walk humbly with the Lord. Have a blessed day, my friends. Thank you.